Well, this is basically a synthesis of all the talks that we have heard the whole day. This does not include the workshop. I was not able to participate. Okay, so please listen carefully and hopefully you will be able to get the essence of the forum. The first talk given by Dr. Francis de los Reyes is about engineering microbes for the benefit of mankind in terms of environmental application. We discuss how the structure function continuum tells us how the structure dictates function and determines the activities of specific microbiotics. Specifically, his study was about the use of fat, oil, and grease, commonly termed as fog, from the domestic waste and how to use it as a source of energy. This can potentially cover for about 60% of waste and wastewater treatment energy demands. Now, using metagenomics, his team was able to determine which microbes are present in fog and which one is responsible for metabolic engineering. This shows that omics are tools that can actually aid scientists in harnessing the potential of microbes for a benefit. It is to answer other questions besides which organisms are present, such as which processes and functions are present in a particular microbiome, and how these can help in solving our problems such as waste reduction and alternative sources of energy. But he ended this talk by emphasizing how convergence among scientists will promote data sharing and innovation, opening for more opportunities to collaborate with the scientists in different disciplines. Now, the diversity of microorganisms in the environment, mainly the marine sediment, sponges, and metabolites mentioned in this forum, opens a rich and vital source of metabolites for use in the healthcare industry, like the newly discovered compounds by the group of academician Giselle Concepcion, as well as, of course, the group of Dr. Laura Lindley-Sen. Now, these compounds provide us alternative solutions to our current problems, like the antimicrobial resistance, as well as provide us an opportunity to advance economically by exploiting the production and use of these compounds. Then we have the talk of Dr. Cecilia Conaco. It was about the adaptation of two types of sponges in ocean acidification by laboratory stimulation. The Philippines, being situated in the coral triangle, has a very rich marine biodiversity and is an essential place to study marine microbiomes. Sponges are animals of interest because of its importance in marine ecosystems by playing a role in nutrient cycling, food and habitat provision, and as microbial biodiversity reserve. Now, our research is about the holobiont dynamics, or how microbes interact with their host and help with adaptation, stability, or death of the host. Their team found that the Cultureous sponge, which has lower microbial biodiversity, has higher mortality under stress, such as high temperature and pH compared to the Cilicius sponge. Now, the results show us how the environment plays a very crucial role in adaptation and in extension of evolution for organisms, both micro and macro. It also shows how transcriptomics unravel changes to both sponge and microbiome activity in particular environmental stress in order to survive. Now, available methods like the LC-MS was discussed by Dr. Leopold Gillet, who's talk on environmental monitoring and proteomics of natural toxins. These are actually crucial and should be exploited further to advance current omics studies and translate the data to practical applications in the community. However, there should be feedback and development. We must also be open to exploring new methods. Then we had a lively discussion. Dr. De Los Reyes talked about how collaboration among scientists from different disciplines proved to be a great challenge. Fortunately, this gap can be addressed by using proper interface, in other words, using the same language which all the collaborators could understand. Aside from different languages among scientists from different disciplines, the relay of results from the scientific community to the general public is another problem we have to tackle. Dr. Conaco suggested that using simple analogies where everyone can relate to is a good way of reaching more audience. Further, Dr. Concepcion added that the research can be more inclusive by involving the locals, such as fisher folks in sampling sites. This can help engage more people to participate in research for the betterment of building science and technology. Dr. Ilag showed the possibilities how our results from the laboratory could become products, which can also generate profit and could have more impact other than publications and finance. Now, the talk with Dr. Walker Ladinia was about the creation of a low-carbon society by shifting from the non-renewable fuel sources to more sustainable ways, such as biofuels. Now, one example is the use of butanol produced by a metabolically engineered strain of E. coli, how butanol production can be optimized through genetic changes or transfer of the system to cyanobacteria. Dr. Delisa in her talk emphasized that more anthropogenic activity relates to lower diversity of microorganisms. It should be kept in mind in policies to coordinate microbial resource mining and environmental protection should be increased. As exemplified by the group of Dr. Delisa, communities appreciate scientists going back to community and making science-based policy recommendations. This practice should be adopted by more groups. Now, there was a discussion on recommendations on an interdisciplinary approach to solve marine pollution in the Philippines. It was emphasized that we put into practice what we know and come up with new treatment pathways and technologies. We should do a better job in pointing out problems to policymakers and in communicating what we do and how the public could benefit from it. Exploit interfaces. People who know a lot about something and understand a little about something else, that's where innovation comes in. Talk to allied professions to solve problems in an interdisciplinary manner. So the bottom line of our discussions here, the main points discussed in this forum emphasize the utility of omics to answer questions on environmental protection and healthcare. It is to utilize these tools for other benefits, such as waste production and alternative sources of renewable energy for the benefit of the people through cooperation with the local government. Moreover, it is to learn from the diversity of nature in order to learn new methods of coping with environmental stress and discover novel metabolites that may be helpful to health and industry. I would like to acknowledge my colleagues from the Institute of Biology in Diliman in helping me come up with these great services. Thank you so much.
Wow, what a great and comprehensive synthesis. Thank you very much, Dr. Rivera and his team. Before we close, may I ask the first to please come forward, receive a simple token of our appreciation, tokens of the National Academy of Science and Technology. First, Dr. Francis de los Reyes, the third. Last but not the least, Dr. Berlin Delisa. Certificates can be claimed outside your certificate of appearance, certificate of participation. So now, I turn over the microphone to the co-academician of the FFS for the closing remarks.
This is the issue's part. I think everybody will agree with me that we have a very productive and fruitful day. And for that, we have to thank the organizers of this forum, siyempre, NASD, National Academy of Science and Technology, the DSM, specifically the Education Group, the Microbiology Consortium, headed by Dr. Raimundo and Dr. Windell Rivera, and of course, the Microbiology Division of IBS. Sila ang mga workforce. And then, of course, our esteemed speakers. I would say they are the cream of the crop of Philippine microbiology. And I learned a lot from the lecturers. So thank you very much, Dr. Francis de los Reyes de Bury, of course, the Admission Estela Concepcion, Dr. Cecilia Monaco, Dr. Yoko Gilag, Dr. Walter Navilla, and Dr. Coralie Elisa. Thank you very much for sharing your expertise. I learned a lot from your lectures. And of course, the participants on this forum, you remain very active. Nakita ko yung sa mga forum, everybody is participating in the discussion. So thank you very much. And so we end a very fruitful day.